It started with a few cases of what seemed like pneumonia. But Chinese officials quickly realized it was a new kind of virus, one that could cause infections in animals and humans.
This new coronavirus was initially traced to live animals.
The Chinese confirming that it is now spreading from human to human.
By mid-January, less than a month after it had emerged in Wuhan, China, at least 17 people had died. Hundreds have been infected across Eastern Asia. And one case was confirmed in the US.
Most people are actually stressed because their flights are being canceled.
But why is the coronavirus, a type of respiratory virus, causing global concern?
A respiratory virus is what infectious disease experts fear the most because you cough, you sneeze, you're in the same airspace, and it can spread very quickly.
Just like the measles outbreak in 2019.
That's why measles is the most contagious disease on Earth, because those droplets can hang in the air for 2 hours, and if you haven't been vaccinated and you walk through in 2 hours, you're 90% chance you will get sick.
It's unclear how easily the new virus spreads, and lack of information only adds to the confusion. There is, however, actual concern that this outbreak will be similar to the SARS epidemic in 2002, where the virus spread from China to more than a dozen countries. That time, over 8,000 people were infected and more than 700 people died. But why are pandemics like this one, Zika and Ebola, continuing to emerge in the same parts of the world?
Emerging diseases come from specific regions on the planet. We call them the hotspots for emerging disease. Places like Southeast Asia, South Asia, Central West Africa, and Latin America. These are areas with a lot of wildlife, a lot of diversity. When humans come into contact with those wildlife species, we have a chance of picking up the viruses.
Since the SARS epidemic, many countries, including the US, have implemented multiple plans to stop the spread of these type of viruses.
I think health officials think that we are much better prepared now, especially after Ebola. Chinese scientists were able to sequence the genome of this virus very quickly, post it online for people to see, and when that's shared, that information, scientists can work very hard to figure out diagnostics.
Chinese authorities have shut down rail and bus lines, canceled hundreds of flights, and cut off highways from the epicenter of the outbreak. And to protect against infection from this and other viruses, the CDC recommends basic hygiene techniques, like constantly washing hands, staying hydrated, and coughing into one's arm or a tissue.